e-learning, courseware development, computer-based training. There are so many names about what we try to do when we involve a teacher, a learner, and a computer. Now, when we talk about a computer, generally there's some software and a few hardware peripherals involved, possibly. So what I'm going to talk about is the software stuff. When you use e-learning, you're generally trying to engage all of the senses. So in the same way that I'm standing here talking to you from my computer screen, but it's best if I engage with you using voice, using a little bit of action, a bit of video. We might have some words. We've got some graphics, some icons that you're familiar with. What else do we have? Graphics, sound, video, words, but most importantly, you. You're the person with the knowledge, and you're the person who's got the ability to wrap it all up and deliver it to your students in a meaningful way. So let's start at the top. Now, across the top here, we've got some applications, some software applications, which you can use to create media. You'll notice that we've got free products like Earth and View, we've got good old Microsoft Paint. What else have we got? Photo Story, that's another free one. Audacity, that helps you create sound files, record music, do all sorts of things. Let's see. Oh, there's another product up here which is free from Microsoft, and I need to say here that we don't endorse any particular software brand, but some of the software we have is great to use, and if it's great to use, we should talk about it. The learning essentials for teachers and students are a bunch of free add-ins which provide templates for the Microsoft Office range of products, your Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, which are already installed on your computer. So if you've got great things that you can add on to what you've already got, you might as well use them. What else have we got? Equally with Microsoft, Google provides some really great tools. Picasa is a personal favourite of mine because it allows me to get my digital photographs from my camera, get them onto a hard disk, organise them, and then if I want to, publish them to a web site, free of charge, private or public, so I don't need to share my family photographs with the entire world. Education photographs that I want to share, I make them publicly available. What else have we got? Snagit. Now, Snagit is one of my personal favourites because every now and then you need to capture something off a screen. And pressing print screen doesn't quite cut it sometimes. You need to capture, manipulate it a little bit, add a label to it, and then paste it into whatever you're using, Word or PowerPoint or any of those sort of tools. Now, Snagit really allows you to do that in a way that is best demonstrated rather than talked about, so I won't continue any further with it, but we'll be aiming to get all of you a copy of that tool if it's beneficial to you. So what else have we got up here? Google Earth, another big favourite, that's free, and it doesn't matter whether you're teaching geography through to history, through to a whole bunch of other subjects, Google Earth makes a big difference to the way you actually view the world, literally. Sonic Fire Pro. One of the things I find when you're actually creating a learning story is that music can either get people interested, it can keep the momentum going, or you can end with a bang. Now, if you're not musically inclined like me, well, you need something that's royalty-free, doesn't infringe any copyright, sounds really good, starts and finishes when you want it, and allows you to legally include it in the courseware or the material that you're presenting. Well, Sonic Fire Pro is a product that I really think is great. It costs a little bit for libraries. You may not necessarily have it out in the schools, But what we'll do is we'll have that here as a service to provide you with timed bits of music that fits your genre or what you're actually looking at teaching in the time slots that you want. So you might want a 1 minute or a 33 second intro clip. We can provide that for you. So there's some of the tools that are available either on your computer right now or available for us to provide services to you, and that's what we're about. We're about actually helping you out.